Our ideas of education take too narrow and too low a range. There is a need of a broader scope, a higher aim. True education means more than the pursual of a certain course of study. It means more than a preparation for the life that now is. It has to do with the whole being, with the whole period of existence possible to man. It is the harmonious development of the physical, the mental, the spiritual powers. It prepares the student for the joy of service in this world and for the higher joy of wider service in the world to come. When does man exist? We go to the book of Jeremiah, chapter 1, verse 5. The Bible says, "Before I formed thee in the womb, I knew thee." So a man begins existing when there is fertilization inside the womb. So true education begins when you are still inside your mother's womb. It covers the whole period of existence possible to man. So education does not begin when you go to preschool, when you go to primary school, when you go to university. Education begins from the time when you are conceived in your mother's womb. And education continues, whether you know it or you don't know it. With education, it happens around you. Everything around you is education. What you look at, what you listen to, what you touch, all that is part of education. Everything around you, you are designed to be learning constantly from the time of conception until the time you lie on the grave. So the question is, since we know if I'm looking for silver, I know where it is mined. If I'm looking for diamonds, I know where to go. If I'm looking for gold, I know where to go. If I'm looking for metals, I know where to go. But where do I go in order for me to get education? Where do I go for me to get this wisdom? Where do I go for me to receive this true education? You know, we talk about experts and professors in universities and theology, universities of science, universities of engineering. And when we get there, we sit under learned men who have spent years and years researching, doing experiments, learning, and many things which are useful, and they teach them to us as we become their students. But there's a God in heaven who did not do research, who did not do experiments, who is the fountain and the source of all knowledge. The Bible calls that concept the omniscient element of God. The God who understands engineering, he does not need to be in an engineering lab for him to understand engineering. The God whom the Bible calls in the book of Daniel chapter 8, the wonderful numberer, the one who understands calculus, the one who founded algebra, the God who founded the laws of science, the God who founded the laws of physics, the principles under which accountants work with, the God who is the one who founded the philosophies that engineers work with, the God who founded the principles of physics, the God who founded language, literature, the God who understands everything, and he does not need to learn it. He is the God who is the right one to be the authority in education. What the world needs is not educated men in the minds only, but men who are also educated in morality, men who have moral integrity.